Hey everyone, Doug here with B&H. Today we're looking at the LiveU Go Solo Video Encoder. It's intended for all sorts of live streamers, especially those who travel, capture events, shoot news, vlog, or even teach. It's the size and simplicity of the Go Solo that make it a powerful streaming device. And the one we have here supports both SDI and HDMI, so you can connect pretty much any camera to the Go Solo. And its cellular bonding capabilities make it a professional, reliable tool in just about any situation. And that's actually a great place to start here. The Go Solo is small, but it supports three different types of connections: USB cellular modems, Wi-Fi, which is built in, and hardwired Ethernet. Even better, it can bond these connections. Yes, all of them, to give you as much bandwidth and stability as possible. Bonding combines the strength of multiple connections into one, letting you stream uninterrupted. I'm going to show you a live test in the field soon enough, but let's just cover some specs for now. This unit is designed to be portable. The basic idea with the Go Solo is that after setting it up, you only have to press one button to fire up your stream and connect to YouTube, Facebook, Twitch, or a wide number of platforms. Video can be encoded and streamed up to 1080p at 60fps, which is why we're shooting this in 60fps, and it should cover most streaming needs. The configuration is actually done outside the unit for the most part. Connection types, video signals, and networking information can be found by scrolling through the menus, but otherwise it's all done through the Go Solo's configuration webpage, solo.liveu.tv. We're shooting in 60fps today, as I said, to match our little demo, so let me show you. Welcome to the great outdoors. Well, we're actually underground, subterranean, but we're trying to escape some of the sunlight, some of the noise outside, a lot of construction around here. Right now, I've got the LiveU Go Solo configuration page. This is just a mobile website. It's pretty much the same on the desktop, so when I show you screen grabs, it's gonna be from the desktop equivalent. But right now, we're gonna do this in real time. What I'm gonna do is set up a live Facebook event on their website. Now, the front page, you can see the unit attached, connected. It's got full cell strength. And at the bottom, we can add our streaming destinations. So I'm gonna add one. Now you have a few options over here. You have Facebook, YouTube, Vimeo, and a bunch of other platforms, including some multicast platforms, which you'll want if you wanna send to multiple destinations. Right now, you can't configure multiple destinations manually, but you can do it through a multicast. Anyway, so we're gonna go up to Facebook and start an event. Now, on the desktop, this is actually even easier because if you have a desktop browser, it'll automatically prompt you to log in with your Facebook account. On phone, it's slightly harder because it's not an app. You actually do have to manually log in, but I'm already logged in here, so it's not a big deal. All you have to do is add a title, description. Let me do it real quick. LiveU test, outside, we'll call it. And then we're gonna choose the profile. Now I have the camera set for 1080p at 60fps. So I'm gonna choose from the profiles here, 1080p, 60fps. You can actually choose anything from standard definition all the way up to 1080p. And there's even overrides. So at the bottom, after you select the preset, you can then override the bitrate, frame rate, and resolution. Now, privacy, only me, because this is a test. And then publish mode, live. All you have to do is hit submit, and it saves the event, and the system actually sends that over to the Go Solo unit, so you don't have to do anything on the unit itself. The destination is set, and now all we have to do is Jake, my cameraman, if he wants, he can just hit go on the device, and it will connect. Then a few moments, I just refreshed the website, and I can see the current data rate, the input type, and I have a link to the broadcast I'm currently doing. So I could do that in the browser, but it's a little easier if I just go to the Facebook app in this case. So I'm gonna go to my profile page and check, look at this. You can actually see what I'm doing right now on my page live. There was, of course, a bit of a delay. It's even got some auto captions, that's nice. But pretty much it's that easy. So right here we have the LiveU Go Solo unit. As you can see, we have it in the belt pack, so the shooter can put it on their clip if they want. There's also a quarter 20 thread attachment you can get if you want to have it directly on the camera, but we didn't do that today. Now, as you can see here, we have two cellular modems, and these are actually bonded by the device. This gives you the output of both, so you have a really good signal, a lot of bandwidth to use, and the unit can even bond between these cellular modems and Wi-Fi and Ethernet if you have it. There's an Ethernet port right here. So you have a lot of bandwidth pretty much anywhere you go. Now over here we have the HDMI connection going in. There's also SDI if you're so inclined, and that actually might be the more preferred professional solution because it is a little more solid. Now a little bit about the spec, we're streaming at 1080p 60 and that is the maximum that you can do. You can't do 4K, but probably the only real weakness is that you can't use a 4K input. I was hoping it would downscale it to 1080p automatically. I don't need to stream 4K personally, but do be sure that no matter what camera you're using, it has to output maximum 1080p 60. You'll notice there's a battery indicator. It is an internal battery that charges through the DC in. Now you can also attach, let's say, a battery power pack and have it going to the DC in either to power it continuously or to charge it on the go. Altogether, it's still pretty portable. Now, as far as configuration is concerned, there's not much to change here. When you get to the menu, the only real options you have are for the interface selection. So whether you're gonna use the cellular modems, the Ethernet, or the Wi-Fi. And we're gonna stop the stream. All you have to do is hit this, press it again, and it stops. And that's it. One thing I didn't get to mention was the ability to use generic RTMP addresses to stream. For now at least, this is the only way to do immediate streaming, stream now, to platforms like YouTube. Most services do require you to schedule a live stream, though luckily it can all be handled on LiveU's end. So you don't really have to interact much with the host platform. Now, another thing we didn't get to demo was the initial device registration with LiveU. And that's because we received it all set up. But the short version is that you visit the exact same website and register the device there, because it'll be the first time you'll want to do this from a desktop, and you require either a Wi-Fi or Ethernet connection to do so. Anytime the unit is turned on, provided it has a connection, it'll show up as active on the LiveU page. You can even kick off the encodes remotely from the website, which could make it great in a studio setting where the solo is attached to a hardware switcher or a bigger workstation setup. So how portable is portable? As I said before, it's small and light enough to fit on top of a camera's hot shoe. At 132 by 95 by 43 millimeters, and at only 518 grams or 1.14 pounds, it won't burden a mirrorless camera setup. And on a bigger video camera rig, it doesn't add much at all. Looking around it though, the front LCD screen shows video preview along with most of the networking settings we mentioned before. You can choose connection types here, but beyond that, the bottom button is really all you'll need. On the left side is the first USB connection for modem support, Ethernet connection, and DC input. Though it has an internal battery, you can also power and charge the device with a 12 or 16 volt external power bank, provided it has a 5.5 millimeter diameter, 2.1 millimeter center pin barrel connector. On the right side is the second USB port, SDI BNC connection, headphone jack, and a micro SD slot that, according to LiveU, is intended for future uses. Interesting. It really doesn't get much easier than this. Streaming, though bigger than ever, can still be complicated from time to time. The LiveU Go Solo really does everything it can to make setup as painless as possible to a very wide range of platforms. If you produce a lot of live video, this is a great way to get professional, high-quality streaming in a small, portable package. That's it for the LiveU Go Solo. I'm Doug with B&H, and I'll see you next time.